maybe 10, 15 years ago, long form was okay. It's when you know you can practice it because of the platform, the publications. They would give you, even local publications would publish photo essays. Even I think back 80s or 90s, you would have newspapers, magazines that would publish long form work. I've seen your work. I've seen Alex's work. I've seen several other photographers, photojournalists who wanted to stay longer or like delve into a deeper parang reporting on an issue or on a project. And they would give spaces. But today, the idea of long form is quite hard, if I may say. So there's only a few, like, there's only, I think, two ways you can do it. Like, you can do a book about it or an exhibition or a few online platforms that you, that can carry it.
That's why I think the books are important. Do you have anything to say about that, RJ, in terms of your involvement?
Yes, I wanted to try to work out. I think you posed a question about, you know, the problematics of photojournalism and it being art. So, I mean, we have, for example, Magnum Photos, the famous operative agency that's owned by photographers. So I work with them on occasion. You know, there is a market for difficult work, and the reason why there is a market for difficult work and difficult images is so that you're able to support the photographers in these long-term projects. Because not everybody, you know, you get grants, you get you know, some works and exhibitions, but the reason why you know, these fairs exist possibly is or maybe that's the, you know, that's another point where photographers can continue to support the long-term projects. And when the long-term projects are indeed very, very good, then, you know, it will eventually be published into a book. And I think having a book is creating a legacy for important work, especially in contemporary photography.
Well, I just think it's kind of ironic, you know. Way back, the main problem with long form work is space, you know. The space in the newspaper, the physical space in magazines. But now, we have the internet. We have Instagram, we have Twitter, we have Facebook, we have all the means of online magazines. We have so many means of publishing the work. But the thing is, you know, it's very ironic because the attention span of the audience now is like more on more, how do you call this? Acclimatized on shorter, you know, like how many characters in Twitter, how many seconds in Vine, how many photos in Instagram, you know, and how many minutes you can just post in Facebook or YouTube, you know, for that matter. So I think the problem now here, I mean, the challenge now here is like to how to, you know, synchronize. There are many guys who are doing long form, still doing long form documentary as of now, but the problem is still space. You know, ironically, that we have the internet now.
The initial practice that I'm drawn to is doing long form, but here I've worked with like local publications. The longest I can give you is like 2 weeks. Even actually international. I like the idea you can work on a certain project for years. And there's no pressure, and it actually draws other like magazines because they know this is what also Vijay told me when I was starting. He said, just work on it, work on a certain project or advocacy or whatever concerns you, and publications will get drawn into your work and they would hire you because they would believe in you. They would think that you know what you are doing, and it's important, especially if you're like Jess, if you're going to like conflict areas, you can't just, you know, go there without knowing whatever it is.
Rules of the game.
Yeah, I mean,
how to survive.
I went to Marai without expecting anything. Everyone's wearing flak jacket. I was wearing this.
Ray-Bans.
And Ray-Bans.
Good thing I wasn't wearing my hat, but that's, but the thing, that time I was working with Karsten, who Karsten is a veteran of conflict area, so he was telling me what to do. But if I would go there alone, that would be really stupid. So I think it makes you learn as well as a photographer. It's important, that kind of patience. That kind of patience also, many people don't know, many people don't understand that VJ worked on signals for, I don't know, 6 years. That is just something that many photographers, like especially young photographers, should understand.